Working in the 19th and early 20th centuries must have been horrid. And even now, it's hard to imagine the hardships and working conditions most families had to bear, only to have a small wage at the end of it that would hardly provide food on a table or shelter and warmth for adults and children alike. And even though the world was moving at a rapid rate, still illness and disease was rampant out in the streets. And one of the most horrific diseases at the time was known as Phossy jaw. Phossy jaw was an occupational disease affecting those who worked with white phosphorus without any safeguards. In fact, the first case of Phossy jaw was diagnosed by physician Laurentia of Vienna in 1839. The patient was a female Viennese matchstick maker who had been exposed to the phosphorus vapours over a 5-year period. In 1844, Laurentia reported 22 cases of Phossy jaw and established the toxic effects of white phosphorus in matchsticks. White phosphorus is a translucent waxy solid that becomes yellow when exposed to light. For this reason, it is also called yellow phosphorus and was used as a key ingredient for making matches. For the women working in these conditions, the phosphorus would have been left on their fingers, and without washing their hands and without wearing masks, they would be freely breathing in and ingesting the chemical. The symptoms of Phossy jaw would start as suffering painful toothaches and swelling of the gums, but would constantly persist, and eventual tooth loss and recurrent abscesses would slowly eventually lead to dead bone that had separated from the living bone, otherwise known as sequestria. This, from start to finish, would take as little as 6 months to get to the sequestria stage, so for the victims, a slow and painfully traumatic ordeal, with most cases also having brain-affected seizures, in most chronic cases. Surgical removal of the afflicted jawbone could save the patient, otherwise death from organ failure would follow. The disease was extremely painful and disfiguring to the patient, with dying bone tissue rotting away, accompanied by a foul-smelling discharge. However, removal of the jawbone had serious effects on the patient's ability to eat, leading to further health concerns, including malnutrition. In 1888, the disease in the factories had become too much to take, and this was resulting in the Matchgirls strike of 1888 by the women and teenage girls working at the Bryant and May match factory in Bow, London. And although this strike didn't end the use of white phosphorus, it did alert the country to this dangerous chemical, and in 1891, the Salvation Army opened a matchmaking factory, which used the much safer, though more expensive, red phosphorus, as well as campaigning for retailers to get them to only sell red phosphorus matches. In 1906, the use of white phosphorus was prohibited by the International Burney Convention, and these provisions were implemented in national laws over the next few years, and that eventually led to the industrial use of this being ceased, with Phossy jaw now becoming a disease left in the realms of an industrial Victorian past.